In episode 7, Ellie is able to get Joel to a neighborhood not too far away and get him inside a house. She's trying to keep him alive, but he's kind of clinging to life. He's conscious, he can talk, but when he does, he tells Ellie she's got to leave. Leave him behind. She's not willing to do that. Leaving somebody behind was something she had to do once before. When Ellie was growing up in Fedra school, she really just had one friend, Riley. But Riley left, and for 3 weeks, she never returned to the school. It seemed like she was gone forever. Not that Ellie really needed it, but Riley was sort of Ellie's protection at the school. Nobody would pick on Ellie because they knew that they had to deal with Riley. So when Riley left, life sort of became a living hell for Ellie. It wasn't like Ellie would just sit there and take it. She would fight back, but it would lead her to getting in trouble. Because of this, Ellie was pretty frustrated. But one night, Riley came back, sneaking back into the room and visiting her. After the initial, "Where the hell have you been?" kind of talk, Riley reveals to Ellie that she joined the Fireflies. Ellie is in complete shock about this. Everything they've been taught in Fedra school, the Fireflies are the worst of the worst. Now her best friend has joined them. And Riley says, "I will tell you everything, but you have to come with me for a couple hours tonight." Ellie quickly gets dressed, grabs some stuff, and the two sneak out of the window. They start having to sneak through abandoned buildings and alleyways to avoid detection. They do find some alcohol from a dead guy, so that's a win. The two get to a rooftop building, and that's when Ellie says, "All right, spill it. Why'd you join the Fireflies?" Riley explains that one night, when Ellie was in the hole, she snuck out. She was on the way back when a woman popped out of nowhere and said she was impressed with the way that Riley could sneak around and avoid people. She then asked her, "What do you think of Fedra?" And Riley said that they suck. That's all it took. After that, Riley was a Firefly. Well, they both are on opposite sides of viewpoints here because Riley looks at herself like a freedom fighter and Ellie is still slightly Team Fedra. An argument never pops off between the two. They just continue to make their way through the QZ as Ellie follows Riley's lead. Riley leads Ellie to the mall. The mall has been closed for years. No one's supposed to go inside. Fedra shut that down. What Fedra doesn't know is when they recently turned on a power grid, turned on the power to the mall as well. When Ellie walks inside and Riley flips the switch, it's incredible. It's something that Ellie has never seen before. She's amazed. Ellie's a little concerned about infected or whether Fedra will see them, but Riley assures her that the place is clear and there's no way that Fedra's going to be able to see them. It's just them two in the mall alone. Things that we take for granted, like escalators, Ellie's amazed by. She's also amazed at what the people took from the stores. Foot Locker's cleared out. Bath & Body Works, that's chocked full. And Ellie's got a really good point, because Bath & Body Works has some real quality stuff. Riley then leads Ellie to the carousel, something else that Ellie has never seen before. The two are all smiles as they go round and round, drinking that alcohol they found. But when the music stops, Ellie has a question for Riley that's been bothering her. She asks, "Did you leave because you really thought that you could liberate this place?" And Riley takes a little bit of offense to it, saying, "Don't say it like that. It has worked in other places. The Fireflies have actually set things right." And Ellie shoots back, "You know, we could do that too if you come back. We're in Fedra school. We get jobs in Fedra. We change the way that it is." But that was never going to happen for Riley. She's slightly older than Ellie, and she already got her assignment. She was scheduled to do sewage detail. You're not exactly going to change things, cleaning up shit. When she saw that, she panicked and ran, and the longer she was away, the harder it was to come back. Ellie does smile, though, when Riley says, "You were the one thing I missed from that place." They carry on with the tour. They go to a photo booth, take some photos, and then they get to the big one, the arcade. They go game to game having a blast, but the game that they love the most is Mortal Kombat 2. After playing for a bit, Ellie says, "You know, it's getting late. I gotta get back and be up in a couple hours." Riley doesn't want the night to end, but Ellie reassures her that she'll come back the next day. Before Ellie does head back to school, Riley has something to give her. They have to go over to the food court, though, to get it, because that's where Riley's been staying. She's been sleeping in the mall. She found something that she thought that Ellie would really be interested in. It's another book of puns written by the same author. He wrote a sequel. As they're laughing at some of the horrible jokes inside, Ellie sees something out of the corner of her eye, and it's bomb-making material. It forces Riley to come clean that she didn't just stumble upon this place, she was stationed here. Riley tries to assure Ellie that she would never let the Fireflies use those bombs anywhere near, but Ellie says, really? You think they'd listen to you? Ellie gets so upset she starts walking away, but Riley stops her and says, wait, I have to tell you, I'm leaving. They're sending me away to a post in the Atlantic QZ. Tonight's my last night in Boston. I asked Marlene if you could come with me, but she said no. At this point, Ellie has no idea who Marlene is, but she doesn't care. This will be the last time she ever sees her best friend. Ellie is so upset about all of it, she storms off, but she stops herself right before she leaves the mall. She heads back and she starts hearing screaming. She gets really scared for her friend, but what she finds is Riley sitting inside a Halloween shop. The screams were just animatronics. The two start having a conversation where Ellie tries to convince Riley to stay, and Riley tries to convince Ellie that this is what she has to do. They don't want to have their last night together, though, be them two fighting, so they throw on some music, they throw on some Halloween masks to start having fun. But Ellie isn't willing to let this be their last night together. She pulls off her mask and tells Riley, don't go. And Riley looks in her eyes and says, okay. And then Ellie kisses her. As they're chuckling about the fact that they just shared their first kiss, an infected person walks in. Unbeknownst to them, there was an infected person in the mall the entire time, but it was laying dormant. The noise from the music alerted it to the fact that there were people there. And it starts chasing Riley and Ellie through the shop. Ellie is able to kill it, but then she notices that she was bit. And then Riley notices that she was also bit. That's when the panic really sets in. They decide to spend their last moments together. But, of course, Ellie is immune. Riley turned first, and Ellie was forced to kill her. Because of that, Ellie's not willing to let Joel just go. This is what she was talking about when she yelled at Joel and said, I know about loss, because she had to kill her best friend in the worst way possible. It was also the day where she found out that she was immune, because she totally should have turned, but she didn't. She got attached to Riley. Maybe she shouldn't have, considering where they were and the world they lived in, but she did, and she paid the ultimate price for it. So no, she's not willing to let Joel just sit there and die off and move on like it's not a big deal. It's a huge deal to Ellie. She's gotten attached to Joel. So even though Joel is sitting there begging her to go, leave, go on with your life, she's not willing to do it. Ellie looks all over the house for anything that can help her, and then she finds a sewing kit. She used the sewing kit to stitch Joel up for the time being, hoping that the bleeding stops, and then she goes off into the world to try to find help. Actual help. Thank you so much for checking out this recap. Please consider subscribing to the channel and subscribing to my Patreon. Hit thumbs up if you liked it. Smash that thumbs down button if you thought it sucked. If you left a comment, I don't get back to you. I usually don't check the comments unless they're like a super comment. Also, if you don't see the next video up on the end screen, not to worry. It'll be up in a day or two.